my age being gunned down at Sandy Hook, Columbine, and Parkland, but aspires to be an officer in the Army, and as a person who does not feel the need to own a weapon but has fired them, I do not know the exact solution to this problem. But our nation needs to recognize that there is a problem.
As a Vietnam veteran, I've seen my share of death and destruction in a war zone. But there's something particularly awful, horrible, terrible about the senseless murder of students in what is supposed to be a safe zone, which is our schools.
I went by a stopped school bus yesterday on my way to the Capitol, and all I could think of was, oh my God, what if my son was still in school? And I was a mom thinking, maybe my son and my daughter is not going to come home today. That's not acceptable in this country. It is not acceptable in this country.
Thoughts and prayers aren't enough for the grieving parents of the children that lost their lives in Parkland High School. They aren't enough for their siblings. They aren't enough for grandparents. And they aren't enough for friends. And they aren't enough for those of us here today.
I would like to dedicate this to everyone who has lost a life to gun violence.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
Thank you, as a mom who no longer has their son and has a trial to look forward to soon, keep fighting. You guys are amazing. This will go down in history, honestly, and I think you guys are actually going to make the change that this world so desperately needs.
And that's how we change. The march and the rally is great, but I can tell you as a legislator, you start paying attention when you get 50 or 60 or 70 emails. Let's send our legislators 1,000 emails today when we go home. Call our friends. Let's get this done. We owe it to our kids, because I was starting to feel like we would never be able to change it. And then something happened in Parkland, Florida, and the kids that have been on TV are proven to us that they are the future. I don't even tell you kids that anymore. You're not the future. You're our present. We need you now. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
We are, I first believe.